Danny Bro, thanks for Bucks Hyatt.
Says to the frog, hey, and they're at the foot of the lake, foot of the river. Scorpion says, hey, Mr. Toad, give me a ride over the river here. I gotta get to my wife, And the frog says, you kidding me? You're gonna sting me. I'm not, you have my word. And then when the frog takes Scorpion, they're almost at the end of the river right there. The Scorpion stings the frog. And the frog says, but you gave me your word. Scorpion goes, hey, it's my nature. That's Shuli.
That's in his nature. That's in his nature.
He's a doozaya. He's a doozaya. And he don't like anybody better than him. He's a doozaya. He's a doozaya. And he don't like anybody. And he don't like anybody. He's a doozaya.
What?
I don't have bad credit anymore. I did for a little while. I had great credit as well. Credits goes up and down, and it all works out. I get a pension from the WGA.
Does anybody else?
I get a pension from the WGA.
Does anybody else? I don't think so. I have various revenue streams. That's what I do. That's what I do. I have various revenue streams. That's what I do. That's what I do. And my portfolio is diversified. That's what you do. You diversify. You diversify. Market goes down. Housing goes up. It's all comes around. Then you got annuities, your stocks, your bonds, your mutual funds. Just keep.
With me, sodomy, sodomy, beautiful, sodomy, lying, sodomy, super chat, pull over John Eye, sodomy, beautiful, sodomy, poor, super chat, Shuli Show 2 days before, sodomy, beautiful, sodomy, lying, sodomy, super chat, pull over John Eye, sodomy, beautiful, sodomy, poor, super chat, Shuli Show 2 days before, sodomy, beautiful, sodomy, lying. I don't mean super chat will live over John Eye. I don't mean beautiful. I don't mean poor. Super chat Shuli Show 2 days before. I don't mean beautiful. Very, very beautiful. Beautiful, beautiful. Very, very beautiful. I don't mean lie. Very big lie. Lie, lie. very big lion. Broken iron, broken brand, broken penis, broken brand, broken finger, broken brand, broken asshole, broken brand, broken iron, broken brand, smelly penis, broken brand, smelly finger, broken brand, broken. I don't mean beautiful, I don't mean white, I don't mean super chapel with over John Eye. I don't mean beautiful, I don't mean poor, super chap Shuli Show 2 days before. I don't mean beautiful, I don't mean white, I don't mean super chapel with over John Eye. I don't mean beautiful, I don't mean poor. Super chat Shuli Show 2 days before. Me expect big super chats out of me. Can you show me a picture? I told the world. Father, buddy at elementary school, that is an act of violence. They don't hate fucking with my guests, fucking with my friends, fucking with my family. That is an act of violence. I told the world, I done with kids name, I done with Facebook, I done with Instagram, I done with LinkedIn, I done with phone number.
We're having a Twitter war.
I done with white saying, I done with kids name, I done with Facebook, I done with Instagram, I done with LinkedIn, I done with phone number.
We're having a Twitter war.
I told the world. I'm old school. I don't believe in anonymity.
It's time for the Uncle Rico Show. It's time for the Uncle Rico Show. So chug a course, cause here we go. It's
time. Boom! We're doing it.
We.
Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. You want to do it? We're doing it. Bob, you want to do it for him? Do it, Bobby.
Do 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 do.
Boom.
Ladies and gentlemen, welcome one and all to the world famous Uncle Rico Show with your world famous Uncle Rico host, Mr. Mike Bulls. And the Tower of Power, the King of Sting, the Doppler of Copper. Ladies and gentlemen, the Reverend Bob Levy.
Hey, and I'm here too. Hi, everybody.
Hello.
Flash trumpet on the East Coast.
Thank
How about
you.
In the world, bitch?
Uh-huh. Cunt.
Thank you. The G-O-D-L-E-V-Y in the building. We are in the building. Welcome to the Uncle Rico Show. Drunky McGee is live right now, knocking him back. He's extra angry tonight.
Really?
I don't know what's wrong. I don't know what he's so upset about. But apparently Vince is on the outs again.
Get out of here.
I've missed all of his show today. All of his show today. Wow. So I don't know what it's all about. But
God, he'll snipe us.
Yeah. I mean, he's not that dumb. Well, now that I say that.
Silly man.
I hear me saying it, and I realize how dumb I am for even saying that or thinking it.
But what could have Vince done?
What is this now? The Stuttering John podcast.
This is the description for today's show.
Oh, starting streaming. Lady K.I. coping. Shit wears
line. I coping.
Yeah, I coping, Lady K. Menza. What say you? Yeah, he's, I'm telling you, he's knocking him back tonight. Mm. Look.
Nice.
Let's take a peek.
Thanks to Fiber. Hey, John, wonder who got the mandolin. No, Robert, thanks, but that was Lady K is the one with the mandolin. Shitwayer doesn't have the mandolin.
Oh, shut up.
Shitwayer's still got the Oompa Loompa. I really can't blame him.
If I cheated, is that what he said?
Old Craig, thanks for the 2 bucks. How do you falling for Vince false info?
Now what happened with him and Vince? Yeah. Does anybody know?
I don't know.
It's not like Vince to give false information. That's weird. You don't see that coming. Stupid. He'll be back. What's the price for Vince to come back now? It's always a price. You know what our price is here? Nothing. You ain't got to do a goddamn thing but sit back and enjoy. Light them up like Bobby Levy. If you'd like, here's how you can help us. Hit the like button. Hit subscribe. That way we all stay connected. Hit the notification button. That way you know when we're live. We're jumping around here, there, everywhere. And most importantly, member up. Get yourself a membership. We got new shows coming up. We got 2 bonus shows. Hello, Gener. We all bow to the Gener. So, yes, member up. 5 gets you in, 10 gets you everything. Access to the Discord, all kinds of bonus shit. Extra shows, archive shows, dabbies, all kinds of good shit. So member yourself up. And if you can't swing it, well, then by all means, turn on accept gifted memberships. Do yourself a favor, because people around these parts, they like gifted memberships like Magellan.
Gifted 5 membership machine.
So if you don't have it unlocked, then you're not going to get it. All right. So that's kind of stupid. You know, as Jews, we can't comprehend that. It's free. Grab it. You know. Thank you. Scotty French. He's doing it himself. He says, yeah.
Behind my paywall.
That's what he said, nice. And I respect that. Hey, good venting, boys. Or good evening, boys. Hashtag fancy skull. Yes, that is the one and only fancy hippo. And yes, you get a fancy skull. Where is it? Here it is.
Skull.
No, that was
Katie's wiener is yummy.
Skull.
There you go, hippo. I always give you what you need. Hayes for Horses, 1 month member. Thank you. Feeling the rain in my knee, Bob.
Oh, no.
Look at that.
Oh, okay. You see?
Now you can relate.
Yeah, they all know what I'm talking about.
John's Cat Xavier, my favorite time of the night. Well, thank you. Mm-hmm. Ours too. Dean Shock, had to do it on my own this month. Thanks for all the laughs, boys. Bob, a few words from father to son, please.
If you don't want to eat it, don't fucking eat it, because you're not going to get any fucking thing else to eat, okay? So fucking enjoy it and shut your fucking mouth and just sit at the table till you're done.
Now, that's parenting. That's parenting.
Well, he wants his family, so I have to play.
Hey, the one and only Danny Brophy.
Danny Brophy, thanks for the bucks. Hi.
Membered up by himself. Dill Dog, I'm covered in copper from head to tippy toe, ready to slide into a pool of cool with you fine motherfuckers. Yeah. Let's go. The Dill Dog is in the building, daddy.
Boom.
Look whose name is already back to normal. There you go.
How did, okay.
Wait, do you want to say hi? Go ahead.
No, what was it before?
It was whatever you mangled. He only changes it when you screw it up.
It's perfect.
Thought I was paying for membership all this time. Thanks to the gifters, realized Stuttering John was given every cheat code to life and still failed at it all. Beautiful, Danny Brophy. Thank you. Thanks for the $5. I agree about the weather, Rev. Can you explain barometric pressure to us?
Yeah, it goes please up and down.
Right. It's like John with the diversification song.
Yeah.
Stuttering John should rename his show to Angry Deja Vu because it's the same rerun of failure and sadness every time. Yeah, nothing. Nothing new.
Yeah.
Unless somebody sends him a new picture. Although today he showed his DMs, right?
Well,
did he ever?
Yeah, we should. Oh, okay. Ooh, let's take a look at that.
So to answer your earlier question about what the price is for getting Vince back on his show, it is apparently information about your house.
Oh, about my house?
Yeah, via Dirk.
Okay, well, let me know how much it pays and what they are looking for, because I'm more than happy to make a little side action, you know? go ahead, do these 2 seconds, boys.
He reached out to April and Holt to come up.
What's going on with them?
I hope April goes on.
What happened with her?
I guess they were saying earlier, and we never did get to the clip on BS, but that is April leaving the show, I guess they said.
I don't know. I just heard he was crying in it. So I was like, save it for the end. Bum everybody out. Yeah. I don't know what's going on there. I know what's going on here with my man Reels dropping a dime. Whoa. Let's go. That's Let's go.
I swallow cum.
Thank me.
I need a big dick.
Thank you. Dill dog gift in 10. Let's go.
I swallow cum.
Thank me.
Hey, penis. Diz 5. He went crazy over no-show beer order yesterday. Ooh. Oh. Well, it's pretty odd to me that a guy who screams at every delivery person can't seem to get a delivery when he wants it. And I believe people were saying this in this chat all along when he was treating the delivery people like shit. Like, God forbid he needs something delivered. They're going to be like, by that time, they're going to be like, go fuck yourself.
I'm not right going there.
I don't super chat a lot, but when I do, I only super chat Uncle Rico. Love this shit. FSJ. J Buck in the house. Thank you. Appreciate it. You know who else is in the house covered in fuck sauce? The Johnsons dropping a dove. Come on.
I swallow cum.
Thank me.
Who's got fuck sauce?
They do. All that's all
a
they got.
A lot of it.
You open every cupboard in that house and it's just fuck sauce everywhere.
They bathe in it.
Yeah. J Buck gifting one. Thank you, J Buck.
Florida man.
Did you all enjoy / like Stuttering John when he was on the Howard Stern show? Yeah, absolutely.
Yeah, he was great.
He was fantastic. Mm-hmm. He's fantastic. We've never said anything other than otherwise. You know, he used to fuck it. His laugh was infectious when he would be in there and Gary's getting hammered and he would just be laughing at Gary. I loved it. Loved it.
You would hear the hero of the stupid.
Yeah, and getting his balls busted. It was great. He was but that was him. That wasn't a character. Like he fucked up those things and got, you know, it turned into a great radio. So and we never said we were never fans of his or he didn't, you know, he served his purpose and he did a very good job. MIP gift in one. Thank you. Is that Mason in Portland in your avatar?
Yeah, it looks like him.
Bunny still smoking in the house today, Bunny.
Yes, I am.
Bunny. I love that people remember everything. Skull Nogas, you know what to do. You know what to do. And can I please get a Jeff the Drunk? I need a steak and a shake. Nice. Thanks for the laughs. Thank you. Sour Diesel. All day.
Mm-hmm.
Bob, go ahead.
It was Joel Wolfenkind. Before that, it was Joel Fenstein. Well, right. Yeah, close enough.
Close enough to completely different things, but let the Dabbleverse continue to grow and grow and grow. Love you guys. Bobby, cookies forever. Oh, hey, Dusty. What's going on? What's all this madness about, Carrie? I heard, I haven't seen it, but somebody texted me and said John was threatening me today.
Really?
That we better not do any more shows about him. Now, I don't know if that means no more Rico or no more Blunder or no more new shows about John after that.
Hmm.
I don't know.
Because we're adding a few shows to the lineup. So... And if that's accurate, what he said tonight, then I don't think he's going to be happy with the shows we're adding to the lineup. But the people have spoken. They want what they want, John, and we're going to give it to them. I've come to the this is Donna G, everybody. I've come to the realization that I am too invested in the lives of Dabbleversers. Yes, you got to unplug at some point. I know that sounds ridiculous coming from me and from us, but believe me, we unplug when we get out of here.
Walk away a little bit.
Right. Oh, hey, Don. 6 months, baby. Look at that.
Nice.
Oh, hey, Dale from Syracuse.
And thank you to everybody who was with us on BS this afternoon. The great Don Jameson, the real Don Jameson, joined us, promote his upcoming album. And Discount Don and him were fantastic.
Yeah.
Fantastic.
Yeah, that was a fun show. It's great when you have your idol on, you know?
I know. He's very gracious. He called you his idol for a long time. Yeah. So it was nice.
So excited.
Ordered my FSJ FKB license plate today. Skull. Make sure the S is not like Carl's. Maybe the delivery driver saw one of the 40 signs saying, I didn't order anything, please go away, I'm being harassed. You know, that's another option I didn't think about. Cripson, thank you very much. Stuttering John put hard times on his own liver, daddy. Look at that, 8 months. Mm-hmm. Appreciate it. Hard time, daddy. All right, so we got a couple things. We got the rest of last night. Mm-hmm. Is that the first one? Or you can hit it up. I don't know which one I'm looking at.
Yeah, no promises.
I see two idiots.
You think it's funny? Okay, Mike. Is it funny, Mike?
Probably. I forget what we were talking about.
Okay. We're talking about the fact that he has that random that woman's picture.
Yeah, that's kind of funny.
It is.
You get my point? Stop with the family horse shit.
John, we've been doing that for weeks.
John actually hasn't stopped with the family horse shit.
Come out of the coma, John.
Family.
Yeah. Right.
It's not fucked.
I mean, think about that. He goes, you guys better stop. So we stop, and then he keeps going, and he goes, whenever you guys want to stop, feel free. And we're like, yeah, John, we're not doing anything. But this is our point. This whole thing is forced. Hmm. It's an act. This is what he's got to yell about every day. You know? Right. I got no problem with Melton, but he's got a guy that's posted the thing that he's upset and screaming about us about every day. You got a guy doing that right now, and you don't hear a peep from him about it. Not a peep. That's it. Hmm. So that tells you everything. He's acting. He's full of shit. He doesn't care about any of them.
Fucking cool. Ah, and you guys have always drawn first blood.
Always. Oh my God. It's the same thing every day. It really
every
is.
Every day.
It's like, oh my God.
Oh, hold on. I have a source sending me. John said he was tired of watching
you. Breaking news. Breaking news.
Hit me, dog.
No, you said you had breaking news.
Oh, sorry. Yeah, it says, John said he was tired of watching you watching him, so you had better find a different way to make a living and not make any more shows about him. Got it.
Yeah.
Message received. We'll think about it. We're going to have a meeting after the show tonight, John. We'll get back to you. Shout out to the 1,000 in here. Hit like, hit subscribe, hit notification. Man. We are live. Come on, let's go. Oh, and can I just mention Levy's going to be at Comedy at the Carlson. When are you there?
July 26th, 27th.
The Rickles Room. Now. He's christening the Rickles Room. You got to go check this out. What's their website? Comedy... Is it CarlsonComedy.com?
Carlson Comedy, yeah.
Carlson. Yeah.
And I'm getting the link up on BS Show Live as well.
Thank you, buddy.
Lady K was goofing on my kids from the get-go.
Here we go.
From the get-go.
And
from
then
the
he
lizard?
Says, I always...
from the Geico. I mean, get-go.
Chad always tries to bring family into it. No, Lady K, you did it. You brought it up first. These guys, it's amazing to me. They're guilty of everything they accuse me of. Mm. It's pure projection.
Not showing?
Right. Pretending that I own a motorcycle?
Yeah.
They're a bunch of fucking revisionist history buffs.
Hey, I consider myself a bit of a revisionist history buff, to be honest with you.
See how proud he was of that?
He really like chuckled afterwards. He's like...
They do everything that they say I'm doing, way before I ever did.
You're guilty of what I'm doing.
Silent Mike, you think it's funny that my mother fell?
No. I think it's funny the way you drink like a fucking orangutan. But no,
yeah, that's really funny. Nice elbow fucking ouchie you got there, dude. Man,
never said that we thought that was funny. I didn't.
No. I was just, when he announced, I was just laughing at his acting, like his right. shtick. I wouldn't laugh at it. I don't want your mom falling. I don't want anybody's mom falling. Unless they're a bitch. Thank you. Then they deserve it.
Yeah, find out who did it.
Right.
Find out who's calling.
Right.
Or sending stuff, you know, whatever it is.
Forget about laughing. You don't care enough to find out who sent that order?
Right. Be very
laughing
easy.
Is the least of your priorities right now, sir. Thank you.
I'm happy to hear that. Happy to hear that.
Hey, when he chugs from the bottle, he still keeps that pinky up like a classy gentleman, doesn't he?
The amount of stuff I have on all of you
is
huge. Oh, and this is the best. Shit where he says, oh, John is threatening to dox children. No, 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 no. You threatened. This is the thing they, again, accuse me of. Even, and I got to give handed to Shuli's Anonymous or Hackbars Anonymous. They pointed out the hypocrisy without me even have to do it.
Because you don't do anything, John.
Without me even have to do it.
Yeah. Right.
Good one.
They played shit way of saying, you know, they never.
Look at his eyes. He's extra fucked up today. Yeah. That something's in that OJ.
That's besides Cardiff. Oh, this is today.
This is yesterday.
Yesterday.
Never did anything, and then they play shit where you're going, we have stuff, John. You don't want to go there. We have stuff on you and your family.
Actually, oh, no. This is the day before yesterday.
Oh, okay. Oh, it's tough because it's all the same tired shit, John. But I like this. Narrator says, I got high last night and watched the Uncle Rico replay. I became totally paranoid that Bob knew I was high watching him high. The mind fuck continued as a drunken tunnel drifter laughed at us both. The narrator. Love you, buddy. Thank you.
These guys are amazing.
Thank you.
They are truly amazing. They just forget everything that they say. On a daily basis, Shuli, put down the pot pipe.
I don't have it.
The pot pipe. Little brain. Oh, my God.
Wow.
Shuli, smoking the pot pipe. That's not right.
Put the reefer down. The pot pipe. Oh, God.
Do edibles like me.
Narc, hey, man, who invited the cop to the party?
Hey man, can I have a puff on your pot pipe?
What is that, a chicken pot pipe? Pot pipe. Follow me, I'm the pot piper. Hey.
On a daily basis, Shuli, put down the pot pipe.
Put down your pot pipe.
DJ Dabbles, I know it's all about what grabs you and what, you know, moves you, but if we got a pot pipe song, I mean, my God.
It's fucking with what little brain you have left.
Thank you.
I hope everyone had a great Easter. Sure. I did as well.
Was alone.
As you can see, I was trapped.
Turns out I knew exactly where I hid all the eggs. Found them in record time. I aced it.
Traveling. And again, I missed my flight.
What? How does he do this?
What do you mean, how does he do it? He's a fucking alcoholic. That's how he does it. Bob, I glued pennies all over the kids at the mall threw me in the fountain. They made wishes on me.
They made
wishes on me. So Pat Silent Mike. So Pat Silent Mike. Let's get a pic of his bearded pregnant son. OJ is the best drink for a diabetic. All his sweating is out of control blood sugar. Okay. Mm-hmm. Thank you, Velvet. Ossie jumped down the stairs to get off the phone with Stuttering John. I wasn't there. I don't know that for a fact. John is an FBI agent when it comes to his enemies, kids, family, loved ones, close friends, and he has all that info but can't find out who trolls him. Right. Yeah. Not to mention, this is the guy that repeatedly says, here's what I'm good at. Looking at somebody, sizing them up, and goofing on them. Right?
Right.
Yet the minute he gets goofed on, he has to find pictures, addresses, financial records. Like, this is what you're good at. Being a bitch. That's what you're good at. Hey, boys. John thinks he backed Melton off posting that maybe fake wife pic. He doesn't realize Melton doesn't do shows on Wednesdays. Oh, hey, Don.
Oh, hey, Mark Abatista.
Yeah, believe me, there's a reason why he's not going full blast on Melton. He's scared. Believe me, he's scared. I can smell it on him. Like when we pop into his stream yard in the back, you could smell the fear on him when he sees us back there. Thank you.
I got up at 5 a.m. after watching the Yankees defeat the Astros for the third time. Yeah, babe.
So he's watching the game. So that means he's drunk. By the time the game ends, he passes out.
Yankees. That's Yankees. That's Yankees. That's Yankees. So I got up at 5. I figured 2 hours would be enough to get to the airport. And we got to the airport in half an hour. But Fort Myers Airport, they had about 200 people in the line for the security check.
Wow, that's crazy, because they have a lot of planes at these airports, I noticed.
Yeah, meanwhile, if you get there with enough time, you have to assume that the security, especially you're flying back on a Sunday, right? It's Easter Sunday, right?
Yeah, more.
He went back on Monday, right? Didn't he? I don't remember what day he didn't have a show. But, like, you have to show up with enough time.
Yeah. On a holiday, after a holiday, everybody's traveling, of course.
Yeah, especially Holly. But any weekend, any Sunday return flight anywhere, you got to show up with some time.
Me and two other people who were trying to get on our flight on United. Now, I ain't using Spirit ever again going cross country.
Yes, he will.
Of course. I thought you got a big $100 voucher. What do you mean you'll never use them again?
Yeah,
so
yeah.
The two people he was hanging out with that missed the plane, I guarantee they went drinking.
Well, and then and then James brings up a good point. So the other 200 people all missed their flights too? Must be a real profitable airport.
Frog, definitely clip that, because next flight he's taking, it's Spirit.
Mm-hmm.
But the great thing about American and United is... they immediately
don't want to hear somebody
on...
complain like a fucking child.
Right.
And they just throw you on a different plane.
When you smell like a case of beer and shit, they get you on the next flight immediately.
The next flight, which was an hour later. And I was able to even catch the connecting, although I had to run like OJ through the airport in Newark and the armpit of New Jersey. And then hop on the flight. And I got here at 3 in the afternoon. Got to the pub by 4, only to find out it was closed because Easter.
Wow, how sad.
The first thing he did was he landed, got home at 3, and was at the pub by 4.
Well, because he hasn't had the amount of alcohol that he needs, so he's literally in withdrawal. So you're telling me he goes from the airport to the pub with his luggage?
He doesn't go see his family.
What? Well, I mean, come on.
Then he was traveling on Easter. So, of course, you have to get there early.
Right.
Yeah. I flew home on Easter Sunday from Philly.
I would love to see you two at the same airport. That would be funny.
Well, I was there on time. We would have never run into each other.
In the afternoon. Got to the pub by 4, only to find out it was closed because it was Easter.
Wow. Which is sadder, that he went to the pub or that he was angry that it was closed?
Well, it's not. I mean, the saddest part is that he thinks this story doesn't make him look like an alcoholic loser. That's the saddest part, is he's proudly sharing the fact that he got off of a flight that he originally missed because he was such a drunk the night before. Then he gets off. Then he gets on another flight, lands, goes from the airport to a bar with his luggage.
On Easter, knowing it was Easter.
On Easter, not worried about maybe I'm going to get a call at home or whatever, a visit. Who the fuck knows anything? Nope. Right to the family that matters most, the pub. And it was closed. And he's sitting there going, what? They're not, somebody's not going to stand here and tend bar to an alcoholic on Easter Sunday at 3 p.m? No, they're not. Mm-hmm. Wow.
I got some nice texts from my kids, and it was a nice.
He would talk to them since he wasn't at the bar drinking for the next 5 hours, so probably reached out.
And
I just looked on my Google Maps. Do you want to guess the driving time from LAX to Pickwick Pub?
Did he say he landed LAX? He may have landed Burbank. Burbank's probably the airport. That he went. It's the better airport, but well, LAX is LAX to the pub. That's an hour. That's an hour and a half.
Exactly.
In traffic.
Yeah, hour 22. It says.
Come on, dog. What are you talking about here?
and also,
and 50 now minutes from Burbank.
Yeah.
John craves Kevin's man meat. How dare you tell the truth? Does Kevin's pubic hair ever get stuck in your teeth? Yes. That's John craves Kevin's man meat. How salty is Kevin's man milk? It's very, very salty. Very, very salty.
What is this? Let me prove I can be better. Please, KB. Stuttering John. He's just not that into you. Their newest rom-com getting ready to launch. Shout out to the 1,300 plus in here, about to hit 1,400. Hit like, hit subscribe, turn on accept gifted memberships. Link is in the description. We'll get to your super chats in just a minute.
John craves Kevin's man meat. The scale 1-10, being a newborn baby, 10 being a baboon, how hairy is Kevin? 10. He's baboon. A hairy man for an Irishman.
He's Michael in love. P. He's in love.
Hey, he really is smitten.
Why do you always refer to people by their birth name opposed to stage name? 1993, this invention called the internet came out. You're not special. Well, I'm trying to be respectful to Crazy Cabby. His name was Lee Morozak. When I last spoke to Cabby, he referred to himself as Lee. So I'm being respectful and not to just use his stage name.
Yeah, man. When you think John, you think respectful, you know?
That's what I'm, you know, I'm trying to be a decent human being, which I always am.
Always. which I always am. What is this now? For the last time, there's no graffiti here. Oh, this is becoming a nightmare. Stop calling here, Stevie Tomatoes Bar Grill. Look at the look on John's face in the background of that picture. Put that back up. I love it. Chuckster.
And, you know, dealt with some things. And, yeah, it was a good time.
What was a good time? Not getting into a bar?
Right. That's the things he had to deal with on Easter. Dealt with some things.
I got my TV and my living room set, my entertainment center, all high quality furniture. Hmm. Not like Lady K, who orders all his shit from Amazon. Now, I'll be honest. This couch I'm sitting on is shit from Amazon. This is not my, you know.
So why are you attacking Carl? I mean, he's unbelievable. Yeah. This fucking loser, Carl, orders furniture from Amazon. Oh, yeah, this couch I'm sitting on, calling this guy a loser, from Amazon.
This thing right under me.
When I leave Cali, this shit's going in the dumpster. Johnny Payton, number 8. Yeah. Yeah. Okay. Well, Fatty Patty's trying to drum up some kind of war with me because he's trying to sell tickets. And he knows that by talking about me is the only way anybody in this Dabbleverse has any content.
So, well, if talking about you sold tickets, then why are we papering the room every show we do, John?
And how come you're not out there?
Yeah.
He's got to try and drum up some, like, a war between he and I, but I'm not taking the bait. Patrick is a real meanie for shame. Yeah, well, don't worry. It's only a matter of time.
I'm warning you.
Johnny Payton, NLO Trashy Kid, what do you do now? Expect cry and fuss? I don't know. What should I, whatever shall I do?
Well, you said,
I don't know.
Expect.
Yeah.
Hello. Hello.
Hello.
Hello.
Hello.
Hello.
I guess you like big fat folks.
Hello.
Hello.
Nice.
Hello.
Hello. Hello. I get that his first zinger.
Hello. Yes,
hello. Hello. Hey. I guess you like big fat fucks.
Fake hairstyle.
Fake hairstyle.
Nice zinger glasses.
Boom.
Oh, Adrian from Rocky.
Wow, he's on fire. No wonder you have to dox people. You're fucking terrible at this.
There's a face only a fat fuck could love.
What? Oh, that's a zinger.
That's what I'll do, Johnny.
Wow.
That's what I'll do.
What is a fake hairstyle?
That's a great point. Is he trying to say wig?
I don't know, because a hairstyle is a hairstyle, whatever it is.
Is that stupid for wig? Is that what he's trying to say?
I don't even perhaps think he's trying to say.
What?
The color, maybe? It's pink.
Fake hair? How is that? I don't know. We're all trying to figure out something that he doesn't even know what he said.
Right. Meanwhile, the color of his hair is faker than hers.
Yeah. Starting my podcast soon. Need a nice cowlick for content. is that Chuckster?
Sure is, brother.
Yeah, that's great. Thank you.
When are you going to live your life and stop repeating? There you go.
All I know.
I'm not repeating. This is all new stuff.
Oh, yeah.
This is all new. It's not old. Hello, Daddy. Do you like my profile pic? No, I don't, actually. I don't.
But you don't see the correlation here, John? You don't see the connection here.
Fugly.
It's different.
It sure John, is. You're the goat. They're all scared of you. They wish they had the effect and entertainment way you have. I know.
Fugly checking in.
That was Fugly that putting affect instead of effect. Yeah. John, and since it's a complimentary.
It's always fun seeing our people cross enemy lines for a little bit and come running back. It's fun. It's fun.
But he did that on purpose. He said that he knew that
he was complimentary. Good, he was complimenting John, John would not correct any grammar. He'd have no grammar issues whatsoever.
Hold on. Where the fuck is this? Take some of these.
Take the whole bottle. Save time.
Pan in 2 days.
Yeah, you're probably going to forget tomorrow and the rest of the week. So
just... See, that's not the way you take those. You can't, you're not supposed to miss 2 days.
No.
You know?
No.
No, you're not.
If I don't take this shit, I'll fucking start having seizures.
You just chewing them? Ugh.
Didn't you just chug an entire bottle of orange juice?
Yeah, but like
why not save a little bit?
I've only seen that in the movies because it's fake, I don't know. Has anyone ever chewed a pill and just swallowed it with saliva?
If you really need it, you do.
Really? You've done that?
You don't chew it.
I'm sure I have.
Wow.
Wow.
It's very addicting.
He said choose it like a Flintstone.
See, that couch is real shit way. It's not a blow up. Top shelf rooms to go, baby. Boom. Old Craig, you called cabbie. Yes. Yes. We used to use terms like that.
We used to.
It was their-
My people used to say.
It really sounds like you should be standing on top of a mountain telling the story.
He come to my village.
We use terms such as F slur. 30 years ago.
We call it parquet.
No, that was like 20 years ago. Do we know it was wrong at the time? No.
Yes. Of course.
How is it not wrong? You know what I mean?
Right.
It's
right. It wasn't a compliment.
No.
You know, it wasn't meant for like.
Yeah, you didn't say you when there was gay people in the room.
Right. Right.
Perfect. No. Do we make mistakes? Yes.
Yeah.
That's why, in retrospect, I should have never used those terms. Huh. But then again, it was a different time.
Do you think John
yesterday?
Was...
Yesterday's yeah. a different time.
You know,
yeah. Do you think John never learned to swallow pills when he was a kid?
Hmm.
Right? You think that's what it's all about?
Yeah, these things, I'm telling you, if you don't have anything, you'll chomp it down.
But how does this guy, the one thing he always has around him is a liquid.
Something to drink.
Right.
And you know, Sarah Silverman has been guilty of this. And a lot of other great stand-ups. Hey, Dice Clay.
Hey.
We all have.
Huh?
But it was a different time, a different era.
Let me just grab as many. Let me just grab as many ankles of other people and just pull them on down here with me real quick while I get called out on some shit. I've never seen anybody do this more regularly than John. Yeah. Like the minute you call him out on something, he's like, "Well, what about you know?" Then he just starts naming names. It's crazy. I think you'd fall under questioning, John. Could do some super chat. Stuttering John is faker than this super chat. Hey, Discount Don.
Oh, hey, John's exploding hemorrhoid.
Thank you. My dispensary sucks. I asked for the Bob Levy and they escorted me out. That's not cool. Seven large. That's not cool. How about put down your pot pipe to the song Turn On Your Hot Light? I love that. Mike, do that.
Yes.
You guys tried not talking about family, but John keeps going after your guys' families. Stop with the high road crap. Give him a reason to cry. Every day he has a reason to cry. And Mason, you think if we go, like, it doesn't matter what we do. You understand? We are the basis for him to do a show because he knows that this is successful. He can spin it as many times as he wants, but that's what he's really angry about. So it has nothing to do with his family. I got no beef with his family. They haven't done anything to me. And I personally feel like I don't win by fucking dragging his family into this shit. It doesn't make me feel like a winner. It makes me kind of feel like him. And I'm proud of my family. My family's not a fucking mess. There's nothing to dig up. Go nuts. The new one now is that I'm separated. So it's like, fuck, well, then who the fuck are these people in this goddamn house? I've been listening to some stranger tell me what to do. I mean, hey, Frog.
Oh, hey, Froggy.
I saw every BS in Rico since day one. Haven't seen either in 3 weeks because Bob won't give me the time.
Oh, stop it with the lies.
Would you stop with the times?
No more
once upon
time.
A time, once upon a time, there was love in my life. Once upon a time, there was love in my life. But now Bob is lost in the dark. Nothing I can do. A total eclipse of the heart. I'll do it, Mike.
Oh, listen, it's done now.
Who can forget this? What an OG this son of a bitch is. He thinks downing a container of OJ is healthy. 150 grams of carbs is the equivalent of 33 sugar cubes.
Oh, wow.
Mixed with countless beers. His next delivery will come from a guy in a robe holding a sickle. Wow, that many, huh? 150 grams. Holy shit. Mike's fake mom is really taking a beating. I know. Poor woman. Kelly Clarkson World Order. Fuck yeah. James, I had to talk with my wife about my super chats, which are fake, John. She only listens when we go to sleep. After 1 week, she is on board now. Skull. Look at that. She only listened for 1 week. Wow. And we late to the party. Heart you guys. Go Bills. Michael P in the place to be.
Boom.
Not repeating. A tightly cut trashing my kids compilation would last hours. It's not a bad idea. Mm-hmm. You know, it's funny you should mention that. We got a show we'll be debuting soon that you guys will be in charge of, the audience. I'll explain more as we get closer. But, yeah, John's not going to like it, but you guys will love it. Real World, dropping a dove. Mm-hmm. Thank you, buddy. Rooms to go equals high-quality furniture. The reviews online give it only 1.6 out of 5 stars. Wow. Boy, John, you really do have intelligence to ingest. Yes. Real World, we bought something for my oldest out here from Rooms to Go, and it's piece of shit. It's garbage.
The original name of the company was Rooms to Go Into the Garbage.
It really, that's where it goes. That's where they all end up. Real World gift in 5 as well. Thank you, Julie, my friend.
Network.
One of my favorites, the Looney Tunes critic. She may be pretty, but she's also ugly. People in glass slippers aren't all Cinderellas. It's just funny. Wow. Melton dealt with peak red bar trolling. Stuttering John is bad at this. Oh, hey, Don. Yeah. Yeah. Is Nom saying?
Oh, hey, Nom saying.
Way to go, Vince. You made me push the Grim Reaper off my porch. Way to go, Vince. I love that weekend. Just made me shove the Grim Reaper off my porch. All right, let's go.
You seem sad. Maybe time to suck on a tailpipe.
Ooh.
Nah, you know, jet lag a little bit. You know, I'm trying to get through it.
Mm.
James O'Sullivan.
If you got there in time, you wouldn't have been everywhere, you know?
Yeah, well, yeah.
Get there in time.
Exactly. Look at this chat from James. This is pretty funny.
I get through it. James O'Sullivan, I got to work at the Army tomorrow. What Patreon tier to never see any episode with David
Gunn? He said DG. He didn't say his first and last name. Jesus Christ.
I don't know, man.
Yeah, he just said his first and last name.
Oh, man. That guy came and went, huh? They canceled Jesus.
That guy came and went, huh? Yeah, because you didn't pay him a fucking dime, and he worked on your shore more than anybody else.
Since the dawn of time. That's 3 shows a day about you, but you only talk about them.
Listen.
They do 3 shows about only me.
John, it's just not true. Hmm. We have Blunder and we have Rico. Yeah. And that's it. But we do have some more coming. Then we got the BS show.
So far today, I've mentioned Fatty Patty, Shitwaya, Silent Mike, Zenhauser, Producer Phil, Producer Phil, Producer Phil, Producer Phil, Lady K, Joey C, Producer Phil.
Yeah, but what you don't understand, John, is that's what you talk. Those are the names you bring up every single day. That's what doo-doo baby is saying, baby.
Rain Man, Moonhead Boschetti, Producer Phil. Did I say Producer Phil? That's what I'm trying to tell you. What's your response to lying about Carl graffitiing Stevie Tomatoes? He did. Unless there's somebody else who lives in Kid Coral that makes the same S.
Again, I'm going to need everyone in Cape Coral to write the letter S, please. Right. Thank you.
We're going to have to roadblock the exits to this town, okay?
But how does he know that that's Carl's S?
He has no fucking... Because Vince told him that Carl sent him a signature in a text message. That's how fucking dumb this idiot is.
Sometimes he prints in a text message. That's what
he writes in a text message, he said to him. And John said, oh yeah, that sounds about right.
Oh, God.
It's unbelievable. And then people go, you're a fucking idiot, John. Vince is fucking lying to you. And he goes, hey, Vince, that's not cool. He's too dumb to even know he's been lied to. He has to be told everything. He's fried.
And they have,
and that's coming from me.
Have him on tape. John, fight all these hacks in the ring. Levy first. However they want to do it.
Get it set.
Levy can go first. I don't give a shit.
Get it set, John.
As long as I get to the shit way.
Nah.
Because that's who I'm going to love.
Oh, yeah. Oh, dude.
There you go.
Yeah.
I'm taken. Actually, no, I'm separated, right? All right. Yeah, let's do it. I don't give a shit. What a twist in the storyline that would be. These guys hate each other for years. Now they're fucking. This is unbelievable.
Better bring a couple pillows into that ring with you.
However they want to do it. Levy can go first. I don't give a shit.
Okay.
As long as I get to the shit way.
Set it up.
Because that's who I'm going to love.
Over under 5 minutes, how quickly that'll be a drop in Joe's soundboard. Under. Taking the under.
Yeah, and under.
Hey, Stuttering John, I think Melton had a great show earlier. It was very transformative. Do you agree? Everyone was very entertained.
Hey-o.
Look, if you like trashing the child of somebody, that's your fucking, that's your deal. Then you're okay with it. But Fatty Patty is a nobody. He has no money. He lives in a fucking shitty apartment.
Does anybody have any money?
No, but not when they're fighting with John. Nobody has money, a nice place they live in.
Oh, the show is good no more. It was right. Good, the show. Right.
Their wives are ugly. Their kids are either dumb or they don't have kids at all. The real kiss of death.
What that means.
Uh-oh.
Except Leno.
Yeah. Except Leno.
Yeah.
Head to toe denim. Real man over there.
Las Vegas.
What did he say? He has an apartment in Vegas? He doesn't live in an apartment.
Horrible stand-up.
I don't think so.
And he's got a fugly girlfriend. Fiance with a big-ass nose. Now, that's really? Nose.
That is not a big nose. Look at his nose.
Even bigger than my nose.
No, wow. It's not.
I mean, look at that.
His is almost the same size, and her head is blown up like three times the size of
his. That nose is bigger than mine. Is her nose bigger than mine?
Does he not realize her head isn't that actual size?
No. He still thinks he was the head writer of the Kareem roast. Oh, he's out of his mind.
Those eyes, too. Those are huge fucking eyes.
It's a big picture, you fucking idiot. Holy shit.
Look at the glasses. How big are those fucking glasses?
She's going to attack me.
Out of her head.
Shuli Agar. Where's that drop? I have that here.
Shuli Agar, son of Noga, a person born in Israel. Some kind of alien?
Wow, he's good roasting.
Next will be his mom. That's right.
That's right.
If he's going to start fucking with my kids.
Yeah. Okay. Turbs, when you're done looking for real estate, I need a picture of Melton's mom. Chop, chop, fast, like the money.
He wasn't going to let him get to him. He's not taking the bait, he said.
Right. He's not going to sell tickets. He's not coming to Hackamania. He's not doing any of that.
This shit way. That's who I'm going to love.
I knew it. Thank you.
Hey, Fatty Patty. Maybe I will go to Hackamania.
By the way,
now he's going to Hackamania. Sorry, I changed. I was wrong. Yes, Frog.
I'm pretty sure Melton said that his parents both died when he was really young. So the odds of finding a picture of his mom, I think, are very difficult.
Yeah, but he could have just been saying that to throw people off, you know. If anybody, you'll find it. It's John and his team.
Oh, yeah.
They'll find it. And then it's over.
But for only one reason.
What?
Not to be at that show.
No.
Oh, the only reason he's going to Hackamania.
Big tough guy. You big tough guy when you're far away from me. Let's see how
he's right next to you.
you were behind a female security guard, John. I don't know, you know. He was standing there, no one was around him. Mm-hmm. You could have rushed him at any point.
Right.
You are when you're 2 feet away from me. Don't forget, Fatty Patty. I asked you to come out in the ring. I asked you to come outside. You didn't want to. You had your chance. That's penis right gold. Look, I know you love me. Okay? We've established that you're a fan. I even...
Mountain Dad was arrested in New Jersey in 1936. They have that mugshot. I remember that.
Yeah.
Know who? I have an idea of who you are. Your facts are from people you don't know lying to you on X. No. No, they're not.
No. No.
Frank Futter.
Oh, no, those are my friends. And they've always been telling me the truth. And they'd never lie to me.
Mm. You ever play connect the dots with your liver spots? Yes, all the time. Melton is making money off your children. Fight back. Oh, is he? Is he? Okay. Well, hold on.
Uh-oh. Mm. Uh-oh. Stage two. We're DEFCON 2.
Yeah.
Somebody get me a nephew or a niece.
Where is it?
I'm going to sign Melton's names on adoption papers and then show the pictures of that child.
Oh, yeah. You just wait. I'm going to legally adopt him. What do you think of that?
I don't know her name. What is Fatty Patty's girlfriend's name?
Ask Vince. Yeah. He's the one who got it for you.
Man, you're fugly.
Back to that again. That's what he was urging you? The same picture?
Can't beat him at roasting. I'll give him that.
Wow.
Look at that schnoz. Look at those fucking huge eyes. Note. Fucking hell.
She couldn't look more normal.
Yeah.
I know.
Patty. You fuck with the bull, you get the horns. Frank Futter.
Because that's how eagles fly, Patty.
I work in data analytics and have TSN's real numbers. Well, feel free to DM me. let's see. Frank Futter. Hate to say it, but it's... In the over 30K? No, it's not. So you're not real. I know it's not.
You know what? The DM thing? That's off. DM me now, Frank Futter. No, I don't want to know now.
I don't draw first blood. This is the first time I put this picture up. And I've been waiting on it. I've been sitting on it.
So he's been sitting on it.
Sitting on it. Okay.
That's why I couldn't find it till today.
Yeah. Mom, my substitute teacher's on YouTube doxing somebody's wife.
Joey. Mm-hmm. You're not going to scare me.
You're not going to scare me, Jan.
I'm not afraid of you, Joey.
I'm not afraid of me either.
Bipolar prick.
Rough day.
What was that ending?
Would you rather me say she's fucking a fucking a freak?
Oh my god! Wait a minute! Go back! I don't know what the fuck was happening then.
It's like a backfire almost. Like a
she's fucking a fucking
wait, hold on. I wanna get it.
Would you rather me say she's fucking a fucking
go ahead.
A freak? Like this woman in the picture? So let me make sure I'm not doxing anybody.
Wow.
that always works out well.
I want to make sure there's no doxing in this.
No.
Sure.
Except I'm going to dox my own.
Why stop now?
Now. But that's been out there anyway. Let's see.
There's no way to cover that up, though. Let me see if I can do that.
What is he trying to show, Frog?
I don't know.
His email. His inbox.
Oh. That email that everyone has.
Yeah, exactly.
Let's see. Here he is. Vince, is that you?
Vince is everywhere.
Oh, we just ran out of time there. That's a shame. Oh. Ah, bummer. Bummer. Oh, well. But the good news is package number two is ready to go. We're going to get you to the 2 hour mark and then we're out. So sit back, relax. John is a nerve pill addict. He would have a seizure without them because that's one of the possible withdrawal side effects, not because he suffers from seizures. Interesting. Yeah. Interesting. So it's the not being not taking it correctly is what causes the seizures. He makes it sound like he makes it sound like he takes it because he suffers from seizures.
No, if you don't take it, like if you're taking it a long time, use of it, and you skip 2 days, your fucking body is gonna totally feel it, even though it's basically like a very small amount what he's taking, but the body needs it.
Oh, right. Once it's dependent on it, you take it away from it, it freaks out. Absolutely. Yeah. Hey, Mike, great job using concealer. Pray for a cure is the hashtag.
Is it gone? No, it's not.
It's still there a little bit.
Oh, my God.
It was like a motherfucker.
Hey, get your board out. Let's pick a date on when this thing's finally going to be gone or when he's going to die from it. Who's producer Phil? Exactly. Exactly. That's the way it should be. Will the fake chats be worth real money on the new show with the fake audience that normally as fake chats? Goddamn tunnel digger, is any of this real? I can't confirm or deny. How in the fuck is this guy a fucking teacher? Jim, it's amazing. I don't know what to tell you.
California.
Froggy wants you to sing.
I don't want any.
I don't want anybody else. When I think
about you, I touch myself. I know that part, but I don't know the rest of it. Who sings the song?
The Divinals.
Well, I can tell you who doesn't sing it. You, asshole.
Something more modern.
More modern. Okay. Yeah. Thanks for the wasted $5, John. He wants something
more
modern.
Anybody else? When I think about you, I touch myself. Oh. Anybody else? Oh no, oh no, oh no, ribbit motherfucker.
Remember, for 10 months, Maxwell McNuggets. Thank you, Maxie.
You dumb fuck!
Bobby, I'm traveling at 4 times the speed of light. When's the next Rico? Bzz.
You passed it.
Someone said Stuttering John went from making $400K a year to making $2 insulting super chats. He says, at least I can drink on the job now. Oh, and that is some truth leaking out, much like everything else that leaks out. Shuli and John sitting in a tree, FSJ and FKB. First comes drool, then comes snot, then comes a deformed finger and a baby carriage. I like that it didn't rhyme at the end. I'm a fan of the way that ended.
He's like, fuck it.
Son of Noga from Israel, kneel before Zod. John has plumber's forehead.
Fuck, I never thought of that.
Stuttering John poetry. Shuli Agar, son of Noga, born in Israel, sent my mother food delivery, and that is why she fell. Thank you. I'm a Chinaman. I'm a Chinaman in the bull shop looking for revenge. Checking in. Stuttering John still a moron? Good. Back to show prep. Yeah. Swamp creature Netherlands shouldn't
Neanderthals.
Throw snow. Oh, yeah.
Netherlands.
Close. Mr. Agar, why did your wife say she was separated? Wink News reporting.
Wink News.
Maybe it was wishful thinking. I don't know. He's trying to manifest something. Frog's laugh is quite intoxicating. Well, then you haven't heard it. Live Ween. Let's go.
Frogs.
John is so afraid of his channel getting taken down, he would be so fucked. Yeah,
of course.
He would be. I mean, then he's got to say that. Well, yeah, go ahead.
No, I'm sorry, guy.
No, you go.
No.
I was going to say Ween is something.
No, I meant Shuli go.
Oh, you wanted me to go. Sorry. Well, so yeah, I don't know why, but that's what I was going to say. What were you going to say?
Go fuck yourself.
No, go. Go ahead.
Yeah, go.
That Ween.
I was wondering.
What were you saying?
You want Ween?
Huda. Hello. Mm-hmm. Mensa, Stuttering John didn't get. What is this? Mensa, Stuttering John didn't get.
Episiotomy
separation. Yeah. Oh, I got it. Took me a minute.
Yeah.
All right, let's go.
Hey, everybody. Hey. How are you?
Doing good.
I'm doing fine.
So am I.
This yesterday? What is this?
Yes, this is yesterday when he interviewed that... I forget what her name was, sorry, but some lady.
Lisa Guerrero.
Ooh.
Former, you remember the Best Damn Sports Show with Tom Arnold and mm-hmm. those guys? She was on that show with them. Then she
Are you kidding?
With,
no.
Yeah, well, I was talking to the old guys. Then she was on, then she was like a sideline reporter and stuff. But I watched a little of this interview and I realized, she's a female John. Like, she's just like him.
Yeah.
Glory days, you know, all the money she made, all this great, amazing stuff she did, you know, pretty cool. It's pretty cool to see a female him. I'm like, these two might fucking fall in love with themselves.
Yeah.
We should get a double wedding.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah. She wasn't bad looking at all.
Feel good. The best. Yeah. As Swan would say from the Warriors.
She did?
Interesting. Yeah. A lot going on.
A lot of sweating.
I'm very excited about my guest today. It should be a lot of fun. Mm-hmm. So, you know, we'll kind of limit the Dabbleverse stuff until after she's gone.
Yeah, because you're a pussy.
I'm very excited to interview this woman who's an award-winning journalist. And a Playboy model. And I was married to the great pitcher, Scott Erickson. And she grew up in Huntington Beach.
And
she was on Monday Night Football as a field reporter.
And
I don't know. She's
I don't know.
Seems like a good spirit. She's she does Inside Edition.
Oh no, ribbit motherfucker.
So, Skull.
Hold on. I gotta put this up. This is great. This is going great. Keep removing Mr. and Bessie from all content. Who's leaving him in? Who's playing Imbessie content out there? Maybe I'm missing it. My lost interest cutting him up? Is Tukey playing hours of him? Is Melton? Who? Nobody. Just Vince. Just move on. I'm in love with someone else. His name is DJ Dabbles. Move on. Thank you.
We have a lot to talk about today.
Did you just spit?
No, I did it again. Wow.
What did he put in his mouth? What?
And the baseball season started. They'll be there.
He has chewy beer.
Flower seeds.
Skull.
It was something in his upper lip.
Yeah.
And he just spits it on the fucking ground. And you can't tell me
it's bad attitude.
Maybe it is. Well, you can't tell me it's you can't tell me that this is a trash can there because he throws his fucking cans across the room.
Right.
Oh yeah.
A lot to talk about today.
Maybe the litter box.
I'm not going to get this cowlick out of my hair, so it is what it is.
I'm not going to get this cowlick out of my hair.
We're going to just have to deal with it.
Hey. And we are not going to have to deal. You are going to have to deal with it.
Hopefully he's not drippy during this one because I see him rubbing his nose already.
Yep. Well, I mean, he's back at home with the litter. You know he leaks more at home than anywhere else.
Mm-hmm.
You know he never has two cups of coffee.
I see Hackburst Anonymous is here. Is this the same Hackburst Anonymous from Twitter? Yeah. The guy that said that I should never change my mind?
Booger there?
There was a time I didn't want to punch down. Now I'm kind of enjoying it. Because if these shows are going to do fucking 100 shows about me, then I must be doing something right. Because if they're going to be reporting on me every fucking second, every fucking drool, every booger, every fucking wrinkled shirt.
We're going to be doing this forever.
I mean, first of all, you make it sound like we report on everything you do and it's all right. Like everything you do is correct. You don't make any mistakes. Like, you know what I mean? You're a bumbling idiot. How do you not report on every step?
Anything you can say as just because you know he's going to grab it. So of course. It's just funny just to throw shit out there.
Mm-hmm. Of course. Like you putting on makeup for this interview with this chick.
Yeah, I don't know why he did that.
Bane.
We all know you did it, by the
then
way.
Then we got to, you know, then I got to fucking say, fuck that.
Yeah.
Let me fucking give them a taste of their own medicine.
That's what you got to
do. So Daniel Cohen, who bought Fatty Patty's house. Yeah, that's his fucking fiance. If this fat fuck wants to have some fucking war, well, welcome to it.
So the other day, Fatty Patty was a loser, lived in an apartment. Now he's got the real estate agency of Terbs McGurk, I guess, got him Melton's real estate information. So now he's going, I know who bought your house. No wonder he was so interested in real estate. You still got the fire for it, John. You should go back into it. You should renew your real estate license, the one that you didn't put, you graduated from NYU on. Remember that one?
Oh, because you have to tell the truth on this.
That's right.
Typhoon set called him Vagneck. Look at it.
Oh, my God. I don't have a vag. Oh. Mule, can you yell Vagneck for us in a video and send it to me? All I got is this.
Florida neck.
That's all I got. We need Vagneck when you get a chance, please. Thank you.
Wow.
All I asked you was in Atlantic City was to fucking apologize, but you didn't want to do that. No, you didn't want to do it. You couldn't bring yourself to apologize until I asked you to come outside, and then...
No, he did apologize. Didn't he say, I'm sorry if it...
Whatever. He said, I'm sorry if it upset you. I'm sorry if it I'm sorry if this bothered, or I'm sorry for how you feel about it or something. Yes. It wasn't an apology of like, my bad. Wasn't that. No.
No, it was basically, you know, if you're upset about it, I'm sorry you're offended by it or whatever, you know, whatever happened.
Isn't Vagneck near Freehold? I think you're right.
It's more stout.
Offered your apology. Because you saw how fucking angry I was. And I understand that. I didn't watch any of fucking Moonhead Boschetti with Brennan. I'm not going to watch that fat.
Wait a minute. So you just gave away Paulino's nickname to Boschetti?
What the fuck, dude?
He's Moonhead now?
He's Moonhead now. Mr. Writer over here just fucking took Moonhead from Paulino and put Moonhead on Boschetti.
I thought he was Fathead.
If he knew Boschetti like we knew Boschetti, he'd know to call him Space Cookie.
Right.
Ed, it's not anything that I want to actually engage in. Has nothing to do with Kevin. I'm just not going to watch a guy who stabbed me in the back so many times. Yeah, look at this idiot. Every fake motorcycle, every fake diploma. And then somebody said, every fake motorcycle.
Same person.
I don't have a fake diploma. I don't have a fake motorcycle. But If you want to believe that, not
you just can't prove that you have both right. real both of those things in real right. life.
Nonsense.
Can you hold Go your right. diploma and drive on the motorcycle?
Can you ride by your camera on your motorcycle holding your diploma with 80 pounds of salt in your saddlebags? dummy.
Right ahead. And because it's ridiculous, actually, but you just make yourself look stupid.
God forbid.
Every fake motorcycle. Let's see. Wow. Thanks, Vegas Beer Sales Jerry. Every fake motorcycle, right?
Another ally.
Let's look. Let's take a walk
no, but down check this memory out, though, lane,
surely. Shall we?
Okay. Okay.
Why not? Wow. Wow.
That's a tweet of his.
Look at that.
2018. Wow.
Look at this. But he needed Talk. Help finding one of his own tweets.
Well, of course. He's
maybe he blocked himself.
He should be in an iron lung. Like, this guy has no function other than his mouth and his voice. That's it.
Well, this is on Twitter on August 6th, 2018.
Okay. Go. So you're proving you have a motorcycle by pulling up a picture of your motorcycle from 2018.
Figure. Wow. Looks like the same bike in my garage, doesn't it? Look, check the date.
Okay.
August 6th, 2018 at the pub.
What a shock.
So, but you all want to think that somehow.
So you drive home drunk on a motorcycle, John? Mm. That's, I mean, that's ridiculously so stupid.
Good.
Parking for a garbage.
Yeah, really?
I went home on a motorcycle, just like you wanted to believe. I didn't graduate from NYU. You keep believing in these fantasies. What's next? Santa Claus? The Easter Bunny? What's next? I mean, how many times are you going to fall for the nonsense from Lady K before you start to ask yourself, who's the fucking asshole and who's the truthful famous asshole. Person?
Who's the asshole and who's the truthful famous person? That's my choices.
That's it.
Skull. Ah. That's what a beautiful bike. I bought it black and I had Harley painted that blue color that I saw on a Sportster. And then I put the emblem that I like better than the Heritage sticker. The emblem from the Road King.
But, oh, so you put a different bike emblem on that bike. Isn't that like stolen valor or something?
Yeah.
I'm not a bike guy, so is that cool to do? Doesn't sound like a cool move to do.
Does not sound like something a real motorcycle aficionado would do. You get the one you want. You don't put the...
It's like, oh, I want a Rolls Royce hood ornament on my Hyundai.
Yeah.
You know, like, well,
and let me tell you from experience, that don't fool anybody.
Yeah, I always buy something in a different color and get it painted.
Right.
Steven says, I've never heard of such a thing.
No.
Yeah.
There is my Harley. And yes, I've owned it since 2005. And I own it outright.
Ooh. This means nothing, new. Though. Look at this.
As usual, you guys.
Yeah, exactly. What is it supposed to prove?
Guys will fall for any horse shit because you're a bunch of sheep. You are known to me as the Dabbleverse sheep, the Bochettis of the Dabbleverse, if you will. And I'm going to have to get up in a second.
Oh, no.
And of course, my good buddy Penis Wrinkle is here. Lady K has 2.1K viewers now. Must be doing something right.
You're all fit.
Good for him. Good for him. But yet you're here. So I guess I'm doing something right, aren't I?
No, he's looking on his
phone. It appears so, doesn't it? Penis Wrinkle, I mean, you can't write this. You're bragging about Lady K and you're here.
Thank you.
That's right. That's the same Lady K who tried to get Muttering Jay to post out information for him to be his conduit. Now, Joey C has, according to my sources, has doxed my phone number. Well, Joey, touche, my friend.
Joey.
Watch what happens. Wait for it.
Whoa.
Guys, man.
Uh-oh, wait for it.
You want to play the tough guy. Has begun. When you're not in the same room as me, you can play tough guy.
Mm-hmm.
But as soon as I'm face to face with you, I don't know.
He'll leave StreamYard as soon as he's face to face with you. He'll either block you or he'll run away.
Hmm. Wendy's cat has a good point.
What is Wendy's cat saying? Where is it? His bike pic from 2018 has no license plate on it. Hmm. Is that for real?
Yeah.
Maybe he keeps it in his wallet.
Well, what's that in the back? There's right a license there. Plate. Yeah.
Yeah, it's a white one.
Oh, okay. It is there.
Yeah.
Wendy's cat.
Don't blame
her. Don't listen to cats, Mike, you fucking idiot. Credit wire, credit is due. John does do the best chip imitation. He really does.
24/7.
Live Ween becoming a member. Thank you, buddy. Born of Israel, son of Noga, fake super chat. He is a Jew. The Stuttering John haiku. Thank you, Mr. Spittle. Isn't literally everyone someone's child? Mm-hmm. And that's single mother of five. Please explain. I'm telling you. Son of Noga, it is I, son of Spitting Tooth. Hello. if they do 100 shows a day on me, I must be doing something right. No, drunkies, because you're doing everything wrong. Yes. And that's a fucking bike. Look at that.
Wow.
That's badass. Neil was on Soder's pod. How is KB related? FKB. I don't know, but I know Dan. I know Soder, and he's the fucking best, man. Yeah, I still have pics of my first car, too. Do you, Jay? All of us do, am I right?
Yeah.
Santa has a diploma from NYU. That's more believable than John. Catch a Predator, 100 plus shows. Peds did something right. Yeah. The Easter Bunny too. That's right. I've never seen a great stand-up not do stand-up.
Right.
Ah, what a great point. People in glass houses shouldn't mess with the bull. That's why pencils have you. You're dead to me. Ah, scroll. Thank you, Hobby. The cute pooch. Look at that. Cutie. All right, let's go.
Pulls in like a turtle. This is not a political conversation. Mm-hmm. This is just a conversation of her life. And she's won a lot of awards. And I respect her accomplishments, her tenacity,
and her asshole.
Her ambition.
Hmm.
Take my fluoxamine and
what's so hard about taking pills? I just don't get it.
Oh my god, he's got snot coming down. I hate when he does this so much. And I think he knows that's why he's doing it. Oh, he keeps it in his lip like a dip. Ugh.
Her ambition.
Look, puts it in his lip.
Whoa.
Take my take some more now.
Look at the wetness. Okay. The wetness by more. His nostril.
Two more there.
Ugh.
And then,
get that out of here.
Not to forget, I'll take my amlodipine.
Imagine if she's watching now.
Oh.
You know, it's possible to put them in one hand. And then when you're all done, you put it in.
It's also possible to do all this before you hit go live.
That's even better.
John! Thank you, Gabe. Thank you, Tubbs.
You can definitely bang a 30-year-old. Skola!
John, you got a little something running.
Don't F with the bull in a glass house.
Yeah, it's right here. So, look, you see it. It's coming down.
Close that's to us. Funny.
Like that one.
Very it's shiny, right?
Under bigger and darker.
Yeah. Our left, his right.
Yeah.
They're not liver spots.
We got shiny
spots.
Oh, wait, Sun. Oh, I was going to ask, there's sun spots?
Well, this is what he's claiming because Vince brought it up. So, he needs somebody to, you know, come up with everything for him.
Spots. My liver is perfect. And then I'll be clear if I pass that any boxing match that comes my way.
Oh, good. You're checking with the doctor when you go in for your stress test, you fucking dummy.
Yeah, it would be the funniest thing if he said, you know, I'm thinking about boxing.
Yeah.
You're going to be like, you're out of your fucking mind.
Yeah. Why?
The guy's going to go, what do you mean? Working for like a moving company boxing? He goes, no, like boxing. He goes,
you shit weigher. You ever hear of him? Exactly.
Exactly. That's my point, doc.
Patrick, thanks for the fiver. You were great on Stern. It's sad to see how bad your brain has rotted these past 20 years. You mean this amazing?
Patrick was at the crossroads and he said, do I want to write something funny or just smash his soul into a million pieces? And then he made a hard right. Oh, this can't be true. Is this true? Wait a minute. Where'd that go? God damn it. Somebody put up a chat that Perry's making puddled chicken.
Ooh!
I hope he got permission from me for that.
No, he's making salmon burgers.
Somebody said it's puddled chicken. This will lead to bad stuff here. This is it. Oh yeah, this is Bob's very protective of his puddled chicken. That recipe is not for the public. All right, let's get back.
Mensa brain. Where is Alex Stein? What the fuck happened to him? Daniel August, man.
Still on his nose.
Joey just doxed you on Vimeo. Well,
Joey just doxed you on Vimeo. That makes no sense.
What is Vimeo, by the way?
Vimeo is like a video. Like, what is it? Like a video service, right? Like you can.
Yeah, you pull up videos. Yeah.
You pull up video. It's like a different type of YouTube, okay. I guess.
Yeah. Back when we were off of YouTube because of John Strikes, we were doing the show on Vimeo for Patreon.
Really? Correct. Yeah.
Doxing your number then. You know, I mean, if you want to start doxing my phone number, I mean, that's lame. Penis ring.
You should write him to Joey. Just docks you on a topographical map. See what he says. Joey just docks him on a real media. Nice pull. Joey just docks you on a Commodore 64.
Thanks for the $2. I just like updating you on how successful he is. I don't care. He's still got a mom wife. He still lives in the armpit of New York, known as Rochester.
Rocked.
And he still looks like he does. It doesn't matter to me.
Not only do you live in the armpit, but you look like you do. Boom.
It doesn't matter to me. I've achieved everything I set out to do. He has not.
He just threw up in his mouth and he goes, I have achieved everything I've set out to do.
How about making a few goals now?
Right.
Yeah.
Right. You really? There's no burning desire in you to do, you know, the next stage, the next level, the next grift, whatever.
His band never got a record deal. He's never had publishing deals. He hasn't had any success. So if you think.
Wait, Frog. Yeah, I was just looking at that. You're so. Frog's a genius.
Never forget that, Shuli.
Yeah, yeah. Never. All right, shut up. You're annoying. Shut up. Take it down. Get out of here.
Him having 3,000 people in his room is some barometer of success. I feel bad for you. I really, really do. My driver should be here any minute.
What? He just reading shit.
So you went into
having a conversation into just reading.
Well, now he's doxing the messages between him and his guest. So it's like, we, you know, is this part of the interview of this person?
Oh, I thought he was talking about his beer or something.
Oh, maybe he's saying his driver just got here with his beer. I thought he was reading, like, his guest was updated.
Maybe, yeah, maybe she just showed up. Maybe
she's running late or something.
Here, I've never blocked you. Gabe, thanks for the $2. John, looking forward to the Stern Show on Thursday. That was an April Fool's joke.
I thought for sure
that you guys would have picked up on it. I do it every fucking year.
No, everybody picked up on it, stupid. God. That what he's writing you is a joke. His name is a joke, you idiot.
The same April Fool's joke. And I can't tell you how many people still fall for it.
Nobody. And that's how many. I can tell you. Nobody.
He's the only one that falls for it. People go, hey, I'll look forward to hearing you on there, John.
Do it next April 1st. And I'll continue to do it. And you know what? In all actuality, Howard should have me on. But he's, I guess, smart. I don't know, afraid?
Yeah.
I'm going to be right back. Just going to get my beer.
Put up that picture, Frog, that we had to take down quick. I think there's his there's his forehead.
Oh yeah, look at that.
Wait a minute, that, oh my god, I just,
wow, that's really good. His forehead tee looks like an ass crack. Put that back up.
That's so fucked up. I had no idea what the fuck that was about.
Mule, if you can, record asshole face. Do that one too. We'll use that one. Or whatever, you know, I don't mean to write for you. Whatever you're feeling in the moment, you're good like that.
Ribbit motherfucker.
Get that beer, baby. Yikes.
Oh, God.
Place ain't that big. Where'd he go?
Doesn't even sound he's in the apartment.
Well, first he's got to get hard before he opens the door, so that takes a minute or two.
In case it's a guy. It says they're here.
He's waiting there like a kid waiting for the ice cream truck.
Now DoorDash is fucking back with him. They're like, fuck you. Yeah, we're here, asshole. Come out and meet us. And they're down the road filming him on their phone. They're like, look at this fucking idiot. He's out there in his sweatpants going over his feet.
You like that, you motherfucker?
Yeah, you like that. In Ukraine, we chop your head off.
Hey, at least I'll be right there.
And his guest is waiting for it. So his guest shows up and she's just staring at this.
Yeah. Beer is more important.
Yeah. And she's checking out that screen name the whole time she's up there. Trying to think of a question that's not about the size of your tits or if you ever had anal sex. Give me a second here. Thank you, Chuckster.
Great.
Thank you to the 1400 in here. Hit like, hit subscribe. Thank you, thank you. Appreciate it.
And while we have time.
Yeah.
Bob, when you get Carlson?
Well, yeah. When do you get the call?
Oh, July 26th and 27th. The Riggles Room and the Comedy at the Carlson. Rochester, New York. CarlsonComedy.com. Come on out. Join the Levyverse while you're there. All that stuff.
You don't have to go there to join the Levyverse, but while you're online buying tickets, you know.
You can do it all at one thing.
You can. Shiny boy.
She's waiting in the back right now.
Yep. Yeah. She's waiting.
He's waiting on a porch.
I hope she asks him what the hell happened.
It's a papered room.
The turn has begun.
I don't draw first blood, and that's a fact, Jack.
Oh, we got some a little music.
Come on!
I want to smoke a cigarette all day and drink tea all night. I want to smoke a cigarette all day and drink tea all night.
Beautiful.
Thank you.
True.
I believe that's a brilliant Stacey Allen put that together. Thank you.
Oh, he's coming back.
KB's wiener is yummy.
Oh, boy. Where are you at?
Florida Nick.
There he is. Hey. All right. You heard the call.
So, without further ado, let me bring on my guest. I don't know how DoorDash screwed it up. They said they delivered it. I never got it. But that's not important right now.
Yeah, why were you out there for 5 minutes?
Yeah. Well, the good news is you've had no other issues with DoorDash before that. Really? So I'm sure everything will work out.
I look nice. Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome award-winning journalist. That's gross. And the very beautiful Lisa Guerrero. How are you?
Good. How are you, John? Nice to see you.
Yeah, good to see you. Thanks for finally doing the show.
Of course. My pleasure. I've been busy. What can I say? I've been on the road, been all over the world, chasing bad guys.
I was reading your accomplishments, and I'm like, well, I know you have a birthday coming up in a week.
I do. I feel like I've been really lucky. I've been in the right place in the right time.
Oh, no.
Oh, no.
The Zoom. You know about the turn? This is the Zoom, motherfuckers.
The turn has begun.
The Zoom has begun. Oh, boy. Here we go. What are we about to see? Now, here are your choices. It can be a stutter, a little lockup, right? You know, one of those. It can be snot, which, I mean, it's looking like an even money bet right about now.
That's the safe bet.
Yeah. Could be drool. And if I'm forgetting anything else, I don't know. But God damn it.
Okay, hey, how about this? I never went this far with this. This is really pushing it. The odds are very high.
Mm-hmm. Go ahead.
The snot will roll into his mouth. And that's
dude, you saying that, I almost puke. Dude, I will puke if that happens. But goddamn, that is the green double zero on this roulette wheel of gross.
Well, he just took a very quick sip of beer, so maybe it's a little like burp and backwash, like comes out a little.
Oh, God.
Mm-hmm. You know,
when we do this live show and everybody's, it's going to be like a roller coaster. Everybody's going to be like, oh, and as it's getting closer and closer.
At the right time. I'm in the right place at the wrong time. So I think just through the years, I've been able to have a lot of great experiences. And
no.
I can't even believe I did that sometimes. But
Was he messing with his teeth the whole time? With his tooth? Is that what that was?
No, he just wasn't paying attention.
It was basically the other one, just zoning out.
Here
I am.
Yeah, it's like because I have the
next time do some CGI, put a fucking booger dropping on there. Some Jesus Christ,
earwax something.
Yeah, I mean help us out, asshole.
The thing because I've done so many different things that
you
know, from Stern to Leno to like movies and TV shows, and I'm.
Sheckler says there was a drip. Did we miss a drip?
What?
Hold the goddamn phones.
Okay.
I don't even like.
Hold on, that wasn't. I gotta bring it back some more.
Yeah, his whole lip is so wet; it's hard to tell.
Oh, here we go.
At the right time. I've been in the right place at the wrong time. So I think just through the years, I've been able to have a lot of great experiences. I can't even believe I did that sometimes, but here I am.
I've done so many different things that, you know, from Stern to Leno to like movies and TV shows. And I'm looking at yours. I'm like, Jesus, what hasn't she done? I mean, you're even in Playboy.
Yeah. Yeah. I know. It's just like, it seems to me that I feel very, but it also informs me as a reporter and also as a human being. You know, you have to be understanding what
others are doing. I was going to say, she.
So I think age does that, experience does that as well.
Fair enough.
She's not the reporter that got in trouble. Like,
correct.
Didn't she sue, like, the NFL or something? Was that the one? No?
I don't know.
Oh, she may have had a lawsuit against someone. Maybe. I don't know. Because now she does, like, crime stuff. Mm.
She's not? Somebody said no. Okay.
Okay.
I thought, okay.
She sued the Patriots?
Okay.
She did?
That's football.
It is football.
If something happened. Yeah, no, that was Aaron Andrews.
No, I've got it here. Investigative reporter Lisa Guerrero filed a lawsuit for wrongful termination from the New England Patriots.
Okay.
Hmm.
Born in Santiago, Chile. She moved to the United States when she was a teenager.
Santiago, Chile. I was there twice.
Were you?
Yeah.
Hmm. Wow. I met
from, something about Mary.
That's right. I remember that. And forehead like a movie screen. I remember that. That was good too.
And I literally took her name. Guerrero. Guerrero was her last
Guerrero.
Name. Guerrero.
I'm learning Spanish on Babbel because
I know how to call this Jewish kid my bitch in Spanish. I promised my kid I would learn it.
My daughter speaks fluent Spanish, and she's like, Dad, you got to learn Spanish because I'm Puerto Rican. Yeah. And I know I got to roll my R's. Guerrero.
Yeah, except you got the wrong one.
You fucking suck, you non-R-rolling fuck.
Guerrero.
There you go. You get an A+, John.
Yeah, how were you like 4 or 5 when your mom passed, right?
Jesus Christ, dude. What are you? I mean, he's into some shit, bro. My God. Just spit on it and jam it in there, huh?
I was 8.
I mean, you know, I read it, the whole bio, and I just like, I have this weird thing. I absorb stuff really quickly.
It's alcohol. And, yeah. That's alcohol.
Yeah. Yeah. Oh, wait. I love when he brags about himself and then Frog highlights how he's completely wrong.
The whole bio, and I just like, I have this weird thing. I absorb stuff really quickly. And yeah, how were you like 4 or 5 when your mom passed, right?
I was 8.
And it's just like, it's crazy, but I'm going through everything. And it's like, so tell everybody how you got your start into like this great world of show business.
Yeah, I
you tell him that. I'm going to wipe snot off my face. Go ahead.
My dad raised me, as you know, because my mom died.
I know. You have COVID or a coke problem?
And instead of saying, you can't do that, he took me to the backyard and taught me how to throw a perfect spiral, which I can still throw. How I started.
Was your dad mad that you were a Ram cheerleader instead of the Chargers?
No, by then we had moved to Orange County. So I started in San Diego. When we got to junior high school, we were in, at that point, the Rams played in Anaheim and we lived in Huntington Beach. So they were our home team at that point.
Okay.
And so it made sense for me to try out.
I'm no longer interested in your answer, Lisa. Let me ask you something else.
For the local team. He was proud of me.
I always forget that the Rams played in Anaheim for a while. I always forget about that.
I know. We're really bitter. People from Orange County and the people I grew up with were so pissed. I mean, you buy season tickets, you become a loyal fan, and then...
What's odd? I swear to you, Lisa, when I was a kid, my favorite team was the Rams.
Really? Was it like Deacon Jones, like that era of Rams, or was it Eric Dickerson?
No.
It was the Jack.
Huh?
Let him answer. She's giving him answers that you can just go, yeah.
Right.
Jack and Jim Youngblood and Pat Hayden.
Mm-hmm. Nolan Cromwell, like all those guys. They were so cool. Yeah,
I love that. And then you had your
That's Pat Hayden versus Vince Ferragamo, because Pat lost his job to Vince because Pat got hurt. Vince came in, became a star.
Oh, my God.
So freaking hot that all the women loved him. And he got everybody fired up and said,
like he's tickling himself or something.
California for the Rams.
That's I mean, you're a woman of my dreams. I mean, sports. I'm like, I'm a
sports and a vagina.
Sports lunatic. Like, you know, I mean, I'm a big, well, I'm from New York, so it's all Yankees, Giants, Jets. But well, yeah, Giants, so finally, yeah,
wait a minute. You're a Giants and Jet fan? I've never heard of that.
The Rams
exactly.
Fan.
I never heard.
And a Rams fan on top of that. That's right.
A Ram fan. I rooted for them against the Steelers in the Super Bowl, which they lost. And they had. It was the helmets. It was the collars and the helmets. And I love the helmets.
Whoa.
But
he loves helmets. That's what I heard.
But you're right. They did change.
Uh-oh. I lost Lisa.
Oh, no.
It's a chance to wipe your nose.
There. Okay, here I am. I'm back.
Okay. I lost.
Sorry.
So what were you saying about the...
Yeah, so... That's back at that. But I met him when he comes in. They want to put their mark, put like, you know, let's picture Jerry Glanville. Remember? 2-14. They were... And so that's the only time I was the entertainment director and I pumped in baseball players of the most season. It was amazing. She was on cable. I think that was a part of it. You know what? We can relate, right? Don't judge us. Judge us because we're hilarious.
Yes. But, so why did you only last one season?
Fantastic. Fantastic. I just put Z06 decals on my Stingray because I like it. Oh, okay. Oh, all right. On your Corvette. Mm-hmm. Got it. The sun gets sunspots. Washed up alcoholics get liver spots. There's a difference. Barbara. Hi, this is Barbara Bowie. I think Stuttering John went to CC Cape Coral last week because his bike was shipped across the U.S. and he needed to be there to receive. Hmm. He's moving to Florida after graduation and is spending summer in New York, so it had to get done now. Got it.
Wow.
Makes sense.
Thank you, Vince.
When I was young, hey, it's our buddy Earl. When I was young, I had an uncle that would get drunk and want to fight everyone, ruined every family function. Thanks for the memory. Yeah, this is him, man. If having a picture of something is proof of ownership, you guys should see all the shit I own. Dabble Don Dada, look at that. He had to touch up his makeup. That's where he went. Oh, you're right.
Good call.
She has plastic surgery face. I mean, she's in the entertainment business.
She's pretty old now, right? Like pretty up there.
Yeah, she looks great for her age. Yeah. Lisa Guerrero. Guerrero, nice tits. Yeah. hey, Shuli, son of Noga, did you ever run into Lamont, son of Samford? I am not. Professor.
She's 59.
Yeah, she looks great.
She's looking great. Yeah.
John's 59, so just put that. Keep that in mind. Hey, Lisa, what do you consider a huge harg to be? Like, are you a size queen? Rebellion gift in one. Thank you, Rebellion.
You dumb fuck!
Shuli, son of a Noga. John, son of a bitch. Mason. If there is a God, John will spell his resume out in his alphabet soup and then fucking choke on it. question for Bob. Go ahead, Bob. Yeah.
When John chased Shuli at the hotel lobby, did that technically make him an egor chaser?
Technically. Yeah,
basically.
Like I said earlier, imagine every credible interviewer that interviewed like this snot fountain. Oof. Yeah. We'd learn nothing. We'd know nothing. The Skull Train. So he wasn't a loyal Giants fan. No. And everyone should call him out on that. The makeup. All that shit.
Well, this is Walter Cronkite. Tonight, I'll be interviewing President John F. Kennedy.
President Cronkite, you have a booger going to.
I don't like my show to have a producer to be all pretty. I like it to be raw around the edges.
Stuttering John's face looks like it's eaten itself. Sports vagina. Oh, okay. I like that. Hey, Gene Simmons gifted one. Look at that. Yeah, I heard you're not a big fan of Gene Simmons.
Well, he's just not a good.
He's not a good? All right.
Not a good.
Hey, he's not a good.
Gene Simmons, he's not a good.
Stuttering John wipes his forehead and his ass at the same time. Genius. Mamacita better get a new agent. That's right. And Devin, thanks for a year of laughter. Hey, Devin's a year member now. 12 months, man. Thank you so much. Grab the pork, Joyce. That's right. Everybody, thank you so much for joining us tonight. To everybody who gifted, thank you. To everybody who membered up on their own, thank you. And to everybody who super chatted, thank you so much. You guys have yourself a great night. We will be back.
Shuli.
Huh?
I'm so sorry. I forgot to mention earlier that Allie and Tony's baby gift registry, I don't know what it's called, but it's in the description. The link's in the description to buy something for the baby.
Our TSN couple, Allie and Tony, they met in the chat. Yeah. They fell in love. They are married, and they are about to have a baby. Hmm. So if you'd like to get them a little something, their registry's in the link there. You don't have to. Just a little something they're worth it, man. They're good people. Mm-hmm. They've been with us since the beginning, and you guys are awesome. So thank you for all that you do, all the support that you give. Sign up to Levyverse, CarlsonComedy.com. Bob is going to be there just fucking the shit out of the Rickles room. He gets first dibs on that beauty. Mm-hmm. So get in there and watch how comedy's done, all right? Go get your tickets. And thank you to everybody, man. We'll see you tomorrow afternoon, all right? Hit like, hit subscribe, hit notification, and we'll see you tomorrow. Bye, everybody.
That's all for the Uncle Rico Show. That's all for the Uncle Rico Show. Grab one more beer and shout out,
Skull!
Good.